Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. The problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the third practice test contained in the new SAT study guide just released by College Board. And as you know, the study guide I'm talking about, the redesigned SAT study guide, right? For the exam that will start from 2016 March precisely, okay? So this is problem number 8, practice test 3, section 4, calculator allowed. Okay, so the average number of students per classroom at Central High School from 2000 to 2010 can be modeled by the equation y is equal to 0.56 times x plus 27.2, where x represents the number of years since 2000, and y represents the average number of students per classroom. Which of the following best describes the meaning of the number 0.56 in the equation? Right, so the first thing that you should notice is that this is a linear equation. How do we know that? Because the x has a power of 1, right? The hidden power. So whenever you see the x with the power of 1 and x is the independent variable and y depends on x, you know for sure that y is equal to, well, this entire equation is a linear equation, right? And what does a linear equation mean? It means that for a fixed value of x, for a fixed value of x, for a fixed unit of x, you can say, right, the horizontal unit, there's a fixed unit of y, right? There, for a fixed change of the horizontal, there's a fixed vertical change, right? And that never changes. So for example, if the x was moved by 2 units to the right, y would be moved 2 times 0.56 units up. Right, and that would be the same thing if you were to do from 2 units to 4 units, 4 units to 6 units, right? So for every increment, a fixed increment of the x, you have the same increment for the y, not the same as x, but I mean the same for the y, and then the same for the y after that, as long as the increments are the same. Okay, so this is a linear function, so that means that what it means is that the slope will be the same, right? Because the reason why we have the same fixed distance for y as there's a fixed distance for x is because the slope is the same. The slope is constant, right? The slope is the same. It never changes. And in this case, 0.56 is the slope of this linear equation. Okay, so this is what the question asks. It says, which of the following best describes the meaning of the number 0.56 in the equation, right? So this is the slope. But let's understand what this equation is actually telling us, right? It says the average number of students per classroom, right? Y represents the average number of students per classroom, right? And X represents the number of years. So this whole thing gives you, this whole equation, the Y value, gives you the average number of students per classroom, right? So if you think of, if you set x is equal to 0, you will have the initial, right, the initial number of students per classroom, because and that will be during the year 2000, right? So in the year 2000, you'll have 27.2 average number of students per classroom. Okay, so now as you go along, if you let x is equal to 1, right, in the year 2001, right, that means that you will have 27.2 plus 0.56 added. Okay, so that means you will have 0.56 average students per classroom added to the average in the year 2000, right? So in 2001, you'll have 27.2 plus 0.56, and this sum will be the average number of students per classroom in the year 2001. And the same thing after that, since this is a linear equation, you will constantly have each year, you will have added 0.56 to the average number of students per classroom relative to the previous year, right? So the average number of students per classroom every year will grow by 0.56 students, okay? So let's find that. Let's find this piece of information. The total number of students at the school in 2000. No way, right? Because we found that the total number of, the total number of students is not correct, right? Because we're talking about the average number of students per classroom, right? Because the total number of students is something completely different. It's not talking about the average per classroom. It's talking about the entire the total number, right? Every single all students together in the entire school are summed up here, right? So that's not true. Now B, the average number of students per classroom in 2000. Well, in 2000, as we knew when we said x is equal to 0, 27.2 was the average number of students per classroom, right? So 0.56 is completely different, right? Let's check out C, the estimated increase in the average number of students per classroom each year. That looks really promising because we estimated that each year we're going to add 0.56 students to the average number of students per classroom relative to the previous year. Right? So 2001, as we recall, as we talked about earlier, that in 2001 we'll have 0.56 students added to the average in 2000 that was 27.2. Right? So that would be the new average for 2001, 27.76. Right? That would be so that means that this is really, really, really good. Well, let's see what choice D says, just in case. The estimated difference between the average number of students per classroom until 2010 and in 2000. Now, does that make sense to you? It says the estimated difference between the average number. I mean, we didn't even find the number of the average number of students per classroom in 2010, because that would have to have x is equal to 10. That would be 5.6 plus 27.2, and then we would have to minus the average number of students per classroom in 2000, which was 27.2, and that's completely doesn't make sense. I mean, relative to what we need to find here, right? We're asked to interpret the meaning of 0.56, and as we noted once again, 0.56 is the slope, is the yearly slope, right? And this slope is positive, so that means that there's a yearly steady increase of the average number of students per classroom by 0.56 students, right? So this makes sense that choice C is the closest one, and it's exactly actually what 0.56 should represent. It says the estimated increase in the average number of students per classroom each year, right? Because the slope means change of y divided by the change of x. And that's exactly what we have written in words here. The estimated increase, right? The change of y in the average number of students per classroom each year, right? Right? Per each year, each fixed unit of 1, right? Each year means as x travels 1 unit to the right, there is an estimated increase in the average number of students per classroom, which is 0.56, the change in y. Okay, that's exactly what the question asks. So I hope that you found this tutorial useful for this particular problem. If you'd like to solve tons of math problems as much as possible, if you want to get a lot of practice done before you take the first actual exam, and take exams under time conditions, and that's very important for sections 3 and 4, visit revisedsat.com. I design my own problems. I make practice tests in my prep system. It's free to join. You don't have to pay anything. There's a trial period. It's very easy to sign up. You do through PayPal. If for any reason you don't like it, you can always cancel your subscription really easily in your PayPal account. It's that easy. You won't get charged a penny if you don't like it. No questions asked. Okay? So, thank you for watching, and watch the video in detail. See the video on revisedsat.com. It'll show you in detail, step by step, how your user account will look like in your prep system account. Okay? Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Take care.